daughter, aren't you?
It's just, I never talked to one before.
She's not gonna bite you, unless you ask. Hey, maybe the rain will stop. No, not stopping.
She says I'm too young.
Fuck. I think maybe my brother didn't explain quite right. I guess this is a strange request, but...
Honey, this one time, Guy wanted to watch me pleasure myself with his prosthetic hand. Strange request kind of my thing. Strange request cost.
Whoa, who's the lucky guy?
What's our one goddamn rule?
Ah, Christ, Deborah, don't throw a hissy. Hey, show some respect for the guy who stuffed you with the new towels. Macy's Hotel Collection. That's hotel with an H. Well, you know, go fuck yourself.
No, go fuck yourself.
I'm gonna blast the heat when we get in there. Then hot shower. Then HBO.
I'm gonna smell the soaps.
You're weird, man.
Hey, look.
Shit. Who made the news?
Do you think the manager will recognize us now? Or the hooker lady?
Oh, well, good. I had to use my corny ass school pictures.
We're in business, kids. I also offer a variety of other non-erotic type services. We black market DVDs. I'm also a notary. All right, then. Don't do anything I wouldn't do.
Every school has that kid, right? The kid nobody talks to. But if Wayne comes to talk to you, well, you're fucked.
Hey, watch your language.
Never ate with utensils. It's like an animal.
I once saw him hammer a number two pencil into a dude's hand.
He burned his dad alive. You know that, right? Set him on fire.
He once ate a frog in class, but not like biology class. In English class.
Utensils or no utensils?
Never seen him eat a vegetable, but did see him stab a kid with a carrot.
He beat up my dad. I mean, my dad's an asshole, but ruined Easter.
So, tell me about the night you had your incident with Wayne. Young man?
I told you, he's not gonna talk. I haven't heard him speak a word since.
So what's this for? Is Wayne gonna hear what I say?
No, Wayne's never gonna see this, promise.
We're not recording.
Do you know what that maniac will do to me if he does? Do you remember what happened to Joey Siciliano?
Who's Joey Siciliano?
Exactly. What's that?
Oh, this is from my Instagram.
Wayne is the best guy. Heart of gold, wouldn't hurt a fly.
You can tell us the truth.
This is the truth. Hey there, Wayne. Brother.
Okay, Jesus Christ, just get the hell out of here.
So, Mr. Hikes, we have a few questions.
They ain't mine.
What's that?
Someone was making me sell it. Look, if you guys want the magazines, oh, and the money. I have it.
And what magazines are you referring to?
The titty ones? Wait.
Orlando, we're here to ask you about...
The samurai swords was already in my locker when I got it. I'm gonna just let you talk first.
Orlando, we're here to ask you questions about Wayne McCullough.
Oh.
Did Wayne do that to your eye?
What? No, this? The reason I have this is because Wayne isn't here. I mean, we don't go to the movies together or anything, but Wayne's my boy. Whatever you think he did, he's innocent.
You do know that he burnt down his house with his dad inside, assaulted a man and his boys, bit his nose off, and kidnapped his daughter.
I did not. Listen, this school is full of messed up kids and bullies and shit. Honestly, it's a dangerous place for all of us. We got metal detectors on the doors that don't work. Kids dropping out of school because they're scared to be here. Wayne's been dealt a bad hand. So you're gonna have to find somebody else to squeal on. And I gotta sneak off to my next class. Because with Wayne gone, it's open season on Orlando's out there. Can I bounce?
I have limited resources, but I do everything in my power to protect my students. They think his father got it on the job.
The cancer?
Yeah.
The sergeant had to run in with cancer himself. No, it's okay. It turns out it was not cancer.
I mean, it almost was. It's like I had it, at least for a few hours. Hey, Wayne's gonna be okay. I know you got a sweet spot for the boy.
It ain't Wayne. It was the death of my family. Argus died this morning. My shepherd terrier. He was a good dog. He was loyal. He hated going on walks, which was nice for me because I hate walking too.
I don't get pets. All these people in my neighborhood with these green bags standing around waiting for something to shit. No thanks.
I think maybe there's something in my water, you know? I kept changing the dog food over and over.
What are you talking about?
This is my fourth dog to die in 2 years. Argus. Artemis. Amadeus. Apricot.
Oh, so you're one of those people who name all your dogs the same letter.
That's what you got out of the story.
Ah, what the hell is wrong with me? Four dogs to picture health. Just drop dead? Jesus, it's like I'm fucking cursed!
Yeah. I'm very sorry for your loss.
Maybe you're just a bad pet owner.
This motel sucks. The shower water smells. The blankets stink like basement. This towel's really soft, though. Get up. We're going swimming.
We can't go swimming. We need to be getting on the road, get to Florida. Get my dad's car.
Come on. It's the first sunny day in, like, forever. I deserve a tan. I look like a gallon of milk.
You saw the pictures in the paper. We're, like, wanted or whatever.
Relax. It's not like we're Bonnie or Clyde or something. I'm swimming in this bikini today. You don't want to be there, I can't fucking help you. But this bikini's getting used.
That doesn't look healthy.
What are you, the Prince of England? Ain't you never heard of a mud bath?
No.
Don't.
I'm joking. Who the hell would get into that thing?
Tell me. Ship motel number two. What? Tell me.
Coming through. Well, no one's fucking in that thing. What's up?
What's up with you?
Heading down to Spring Break Daytona, currently on a shitty motel tour all the way there.
Shithole, no doubt.
You know what makes shitty motels seem less shitty? Getting shit-faced. We made pink panty droppers. Join.
All right, here we go. Yeah, cool. All right.
keep anything. Check them out, they telling people it's 10 of me. Well, I guess I got the remedy. The close door was amazing, but jump shot too. Tell me, who do it better? Shut your home.
There you go.
Principal Cole, I have to talk to you.
Orlando, what the? Get out of here!
I'm sorry, are you done using the bathroom?
No, I wasn't. I'm just sitting here.
In the bathroom? Just breathing in all this nasty air?
It's the faculty bathroom. How the hell did you get in here?
I have a key.
To the faculty bathroom? Give me those. Hey, this place, this is for me. This is the only place I have that's for me. It's sacred.
Listen, it's about Wayne.
Oh, well, then in that case, get the hell out of here. As if that kid hasn't caused me enough frickin' vexation.
But we gotta help him.
Look, I know that life has been a little difficult for you lately without your bodyguard, but maybe you shouldn't have done a bunch of stuff that made you need a bodyguard.
But he's in some real trouble. I'm serious. Look, these guys, they're going after him. They're buying bats.
Yeah, maybe the baseball players.
Look what they wrote.
Heading out to Florida to kill that motherfucker, Wayne.
They're going at him with bats and shit. We need to help him.
Do you know how many times I tried to help that kid? How many times I thought, you know, that message I just gave Wayne really hit home and now he's gonna turn his life around, only to have him completely ignore me and remove some kid's teeth with his knuckles or a trumpet? I'm done, Orlando. I'm done.
Florida ain't that far. We could go together. You're the only adult that he listens to.
Go together. Really? Did Wayne say that?
Not really. I gleaned it.
Gleaned it.
Oh, man. Look, Orlando, I'm not about to take one of my 16-year-old students on a road trip. I don't know if you read the papers lately, but it's not a popular thing to do.
Well, what do you got to do anyway? It's spring break in like 2 days. You don't have a wife, no kids, no girlfriend, no dogs now. Everyone knows. No offense, but you ain't got shit.
Hey, watch your language. I do have shit. I have a thing, Mr. Know-It-All. An important thing, actually. I do have shit. So glean that.
Okay, then what you got?
I have a speech to give to a bunch of other principals at a Recharging Hope with Leadership conference, which sounds lame when I say it because it is. Anyway, I gotta be in Charlotte for a few days, so you're gonna have to leave it to the cops.
Hey, North Carolina is on the way to Florida.
Look at that, you know, geography. Look, your buddy Wayne, in case you haven't noticed, he can take care of himself. Me, on the other hand, I can't even take care of my dogs. He stole a key to this bathroom.
So what's the problem? It could be fun.
We shouldn't go out there. People spot us or something.
From those pictures, no one's gonna recognize us. That picture's so old, I'm wearing Oshkosh, but fucking gosh.
What's wrong with staying in here? We got coin nuts and the HBO.
The HBO?
Our face are all over town, I think. We can't just go around being friends with strangers now.
Problem solved. Here's what we do. We'll come up with a cover story, and I'll pretend we're different people, except better than last night's one.
Well, you lie better than me. I can't do it.
Everyone lies better than you. You're like the goddamn beacon of truth. So let's try something a little bit different. Choose a character from the last movie you saw or a book you read or whatever. Take part of their story, make it your own. You think of somebody? Character or whatever?
Conan.
O'Brien?
The Barbarian.
Does Conan even have a last name?
No, just Conan.
You just walk into a party and be like, oh, hey, what's up? I'm Conan the Barbarian.
It would be kind of cool, though.
Listen, I know you don't hear this a lot, but you're thinking too much. The key with this is to tell one big, fat, juicy lie. You know, the important one you need him to believe. Then you follow it up with the tiny little weird bullshit details. You know, nothing real particular, but stuff no one would ever make up. You want to try?
Not really.
I'm Angelica. This is...
John? John? Wayne?
John... Wayne.
Yeah, her parents love westerns. We're in Philadelphia for a conference. You know those tiny little balloons they blow up in your arteries to prevent heart attacks? Well, they sell those to doctors. Two competing companies make them. Our parents each work for one of the companies, so they're like competitors.
My dad had a heart attack.
So, you gonna get bombed with us or what, John Wayne?
John Wayne!
So, I just want to make sure I'm hearing this right. You, the boy's guardian, is authorizing me, an adult male you've never met before today, who's never raised any kids in his life, to take your grandson across multiple state lines, hundreds of miles away in a shoddy tourist to find his friend who may or may not be a criminal.
How much money you guys need for food?
Private hell, I don't like this game anymore.
Ryan, no one dared you to take mushrooms. You just took mushrooms.
We should go.
We're in the middle of a game, bro.
Hey, come on, John Wayne, ease up.
Who's next?
Angelica. Definitely Angelica.
Okay.
Truth or dare, bitch. Well, I want to keep my top on, so.
Boo.
Truth.
Let's see. Where's the craziest place you've ever had sex?
Craziest? Ah, Jesus. Gonna have to give me a sec on this one. Craziest.
All right. Ice rink, summer, last year. My house never really had air conditioning, so when it was hot, I used to go there to read. And this kid, Jimmy DiPietro, had a summer job cleaning the ice on one of those big Zamboni things. You know what those are? It was funny, because even though he was 2 years older than me, he still looked like a little kid behind the wheel of that big thing. Anyway, was on a Zamboni a crazy place to have sex?
Shut it down. This girl just won truth or dare.
Yeah. All right, say Zamboning.
Zamboning.
Bob?
Hey, Tommy. Bruins tonight. Probably gonna get smoked again.
Yeah, probably. Mind if we have a chat?
I'd offer you something, but I don't usually get visitors. Think I got some flat soda or a banana?
I'll take a banana.
Jay.
Wait, Wayne's all right, right?
I solved the case for your dead dogs.
I'm sorry?
Ran down some leads this afternoon. Dug up the toxicology reports from your vet and shared them with Patricia in forensics. Looked up noise reports from your neighbors. Found some hospital records, ran a few background checks.
I helped with those.
He did. Long and short of it, you didn't kill your dogs. Your next-door neighbor did.
They were poisoned.
What?
Antidepressants, SSRIs. His name was all over the prescription. The bright side is they probably were very happy before their heart stopped. Cheerful.
We still haven't determined a motive yet, other than the obvious possibilities. Your neighbor doesn't like you, he doesn't like dogs, or he's just some rotten SOB.
Or he was off his meds on account that he was poisoning your dogs with them.
So it wasn't me. I didn't kill them. Bob fucking Andrews. I should have known. One time my dog shit on his lawn. One time.
And it was one dog. It was like 4 dogs ago. It was the winter. I had the flu. The dog came out. I was going to get him, but it was snowing, and I forgot that cocksucker.
I believe the your words, cocksucker, you're looking for is, in fact, your other neighbor. One Paul Taylor.
Paul Taylor? What the fuck did I ever do to that fucking guy? I'm nice enough to listen to him gab on about his fucking precious fucking Bruins every fucking day. He kills my fucking dogs.
So now you've had the proper amount of time to process this, I'd like to talk to you about something important.
Last time, I'm telling you, go back in the RV and fucking chill. You said taking mushrooms would make me feel good!
All right, John Wayne, you've been awful quiet, and I don't think you've had a turn yet.
No, he is not.
You seem like a dare guy. Fact.
Might got pussy if you're not, so...
Truth. All right, bro. It's the craziest thing that's ever happened to you.
Hey, I think we,
A couple Thanksgivings ago, I broke my brother's record player.
Ooh!
I didn't say anything because I knew he'd go mental, but he knew it was me right off. I was asleep when he came in to give me the first beating. He was 5 years older than me, so it was pretty bad. My dad was away on a job, so there was no one around to stop him. And so every time he'd come home, he'd see that broken record player, he'd get mad all over again. He'd come in, he'd throw me another beating. But one night, I had just about had it, so I got these handcuffs I found in the woods, cuffed him to his bed before he woke up. I got a couple good shots in. I even broke the record player for good. But the cuffs gave out. Anyway, he threw me down the stairs, and I'm guessing he got scared he'd kill me or something when I didn't get up because he called an ambulance. The doctor said I was like a miracle or something because I died for like a whole 2 minutes, but I didn't know what happened because, well, I was dead, I guess.
Shit.
Bullshit. No fucking way that's you. It's not even scientifically possible.
Kick back, dude. It's just a game.
Yeah. Truth or dare. Not big fucking liar, dude. He's a fucking liar.
Was he a good boy?
Yeah, he was one of the good ones. Smarter than he looked. When he did something wrong, took him a while to set him straight, but that's the truth about all of them, one way or another. I'm gonna miss him.
You don't think he's coming back?
Coming back from what?
Wait, we're talking about Wayne, right?
I was talking about Argus, my dog.
You know, I've heard a lot of things about that boy today. A lot of them hard to believe. I guess I'm just asking what I should believe.
Well, I'm not gonna lie, a lot of those stories are true. You know, if you're gonna base your investigation solely on what's in your police files and interviews with people from around this town, you should probably just go find him and lock him up right now. Shit, I could have thrown him out of school 24 times. But I gotta tell you something, that kid has never got a chance. He got the shit end of the stick at every turn, and I can keep trying to ram life lessons down his throat, but until that kid gets one real break or a good thing happening to him, I don't know.
The world's a cruel place.
Fucking A right it is, huh?
So how much vacation time you got saved up?
Doing this or what?
Wayne.
Yeah, listen to your sister. Don't get yourself killed.
Woo!
Truth or dare?
Okay, dare, what you got?
I dare you to get that girly bike, break into one of them rooms upstairs, and jump her through the window into that pool.
Yeah, right, I'm not fucking doing that.
What was it you called me earlier?
A pussy?
I'm not a pussy. I'm just not a fucking idiot. Just because you're a liar doesn't mean I'm gonna do a dare that no one else in their right fucking mind would do. So stick it up your lying piece of shit townie ass.
No, he's just drunk.
John Wayne needs to lighten up.
Or Todd needs to be less of a dick.
Hey, what's this guy's name?
I'm not sure he has one. The higher risk animals tend to move through the system pretty quick, so.
Hey, bud!
Could I actually interest you in some of our other dogs? Because this one is pretty antisocial, quite risk, hates strangers, unsafe with children, hates me a lot, too. He's actually scheduled to be put down.
You believe in second chances, boy?
All right, I'm gonna fire up Slap Cup. Let's get her going.
Yes.
So, did your parents get rich off the balloon thing or what?
Where are you guys from, anyway?
No, tell your brother I think he's a giant pussy.
What the fuck?
John fucking...
Wayne!
I think I shit my pants.
Hey! 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 Hey, I called the cops! All of you, stay where you are!
God.
Oh, shit!
Come on!
Hurry! Get in there.
Jesus! This is your idea of lying low? Oh, shit!
Go, 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 go!
Go! Wait, get down!
Hold it right there! Right there!
Come here! We need to get our stuff.
You know I didn't do what I said I did. On the Zamboni, right?
Okay.
Well, anywhere, actually. Not that it's any of your business.
You're all of legal drinking age, I take it?
Not that it's any of my business, but geez. Your brother's a real piece of work, huh? Can't believe all that. Wait, was it? Lied, you sneaky son of a bitch. Look at you.
Yeah. Just the part about the record player, though. I just made that up.
Oh.
So why was your brother beating on you all the time, then?
I don't know. He was just like that. It was the last time I saw him. My dad gave it to him pretty good when he came back and found out I was hurt. And he left that night. Heard he joined the Marines a few weeks later from a friend. But I did it, though. I got one past you.
Yeah. Yeah, you really did.
If we search that trailer, we won't find any drugs.
We need to go.
He's right there.
I'll get right there.
Stop!
Hey, I got you. Come here.
Don't have him. Put pursuit. Window, suspects possibly heading northbound.
Street side. Take the cruiser around the back of the hotel. I'm on foot. Move out.
I know she's pissed at me.
Paul?
Who is it?
You got a visitor. Meet Wayne. Orlando, it's Principal Cole. Be out front by 6. We're going to Florida. Orlando, tell your grandmother I need $300.
No.
Why? What's wrong?
She took our money. Fuck!
We gotta go.
Too strong. I hope that you will understand. I say these things cause I'd like to know if you're as lonely as I am, and if you'd mind sharing the night together.
It's fucking game time.
Sharing the night together.
Let's fuck shit up.
Sharing the night.
Fuck some shit up, Bridget!
And if tomorrow finds us together right here, the way we are, would you mind sharing the night together?
Fuck it, Addy!
Next on Wayne.
Can't believe that hooker lady robbed us.
We need to get money. Maybe get jobs or something.
What is it with this Wayne kid?
He's got a gut feeling about him. We'll find him.
And her.
My mom taught me how to survive.
You're not gonna steal, right?
Miss.
How was it? Your day or whatever?
Everyone's not nice and I think the boss hates me.
What do they do with him?
Fuck!
You know, I bet he doesn't even remember our birthday tomorrow.
Free hotcakes!
Free motherfucking hotcakes!
Let's kick daddy's ass.
Let's kick his fucking ass.